Welcome to West African Open Education Platform. These are past WASC questions in mathematics 2005. Question 1A. If 2 raised to the power x plus 2 raised to the power into x minus 1 equals to 48, find the value of x. Question 1b. Without using mathematical tables or calculator, evaluate leaving your answer in sums. Sine 45 degrees plus cos 60 degrees all over tan 30 degrees. So you can see this is just a fraction of the past paper that I was using in WASC exam. Now here comes the solution. Solution for 1A. 2 raised to the power x plus 2 raised to the power into x minus 1 equals to 48. Now in indices, you will notice that when you divide, you subtract the power, that is x minus 1, because the bases are the same, so you subtract the index. That's why you see x minus 1 here. So now, if that's the case, you try to simplify this aspect. You have 2 raised to the power x plus 2 raised to the power x all over 2 raised to the power 1 equals to 48. So at the end of the day, you have 2 raised to the power x plus 2 raised to the power x. We know 2 raised to the power 1 is the same as 2. Okay? Equals to 48. Now, if we find the LCM, here, we have 2 into 2 raised to the power x plus 2 raised to the power x all upon 2 is equals to 48. Good. Now, if you simplify, because one, you divide both sides, or you multiply throughout by 2. If you multiply throughout by 2, then you have 2 into 2 raised to the power x plus 2 raised to the power x equals to 2 into 48. Then you have 2 into 2 raised to the power x plus 2 raised to the power x equals to 96. That is by multiplying 2 times 48. That gives you 96. You cannot go further in finding the value of x. Let 2 raised to the power x say equals to y. Then you substitute. You replace this 2x, 2 raised to the power x, by y. And then 2 raised to the power x again by y. Then you have automatically a linear equation. If you remove the bracket, 2 times y gives you 2y plus y equals to 96. So 2y plus y, that gives you 3y equals to 96. Divide both sides by 3. If you divide both sides by 3, and we have y equals to 96 upon 3. Y is equals to 32. That is by cancellation. If you take 3 here is 1, 3 here is 3, and 3 here is 2. That gives you 32. But you note that 2 raised to the power x is equals to y. 2 raised to the power x is equals to y. Therefore, 2 raised to the power x is equals to 32, and 32 we know is 2 raised to the power 5. That when you multiply 2 times 2 times 2 times 2 onto 5 times, then you're going to have 2 raised to the power 5. That gives you 32. Since the base are the same, this is 2 raised to the power x and this is equals to 2 raised to the power y, it equates the index. That is x now is equals to 5. Question number 2. And the question number 1b. Sine 45 plus cos 60 degrees all over 10, 30 degrees. We all know in our last lesson that sine 45 is equals to 1 upon root 2, and cos 60 is equals to half, and tan 30 is equals to 1 upon 3. If you substitute the value, that is, this is sine 45 becomes 1 upon root 2. This is root 2 plus cos 60 is half. All over, you have tan 30 is 1 all over root 3. You simplify, you have 2 plus root 2 upon 2 root 2. You divide it by 1 upon root 3, this one. So after that, you try to take the first fraction, the second fraction, because you are changing this division sign to multiplication sign, you take the reciprocal. That here becomes root 3 upon 1. If you multiply the numerator, this is root 3 into 2 plus root 2. And then all over root 2, 2 root 2 multiplied by 1, same as 2 root 2. So if you simplify further, you have 2 root 3, that is, you open the bracket, 2 times 3, that gives you 2 root 3, and then root 3 times this gives you root 6, all over root 2. So since we are asked to leave our answer in salt, this is the answer for question 1. Thank you.